I know we gotta let you go. Just finally, for you know, there's a lot of folks out there tonight watching or been watching this online or whenever tomorrow. What's your message to them? People are scared. People are worried. They've lost their jobs. They're, you know, they don't know how long they're going to be in their homes. What's your message?
Well, this is a very challenging time, and we're all having to make huge changes to our lives that we never would have expected. People are rising to the challenge, you know, figuring out how to be at their home and reduce their contacts. That's really fantastic. People are figuring out how to volunteer, many cases through virtual connections, tutoring and mentoring. People are giving money to philanthropies in the local areas that are stepping up to find, you know, where people may not have shelter or food, and that's really fantastic. I'm an optimist. We'll be driven by the numbers, but from what we've seen in other countries, if we do this well and nationwide, these numbers will start to come down. And so there'll be a point, you know, hopefully in 10 weeks or less, where we can start going back to normal. That's a long time, though. It's a wild amount of time, and there will be this temptation to let off. Unfortunately, that will just mean that it lasts longer, or that we have to go back and do that again. So, there's no need to panic, even though the change is a bit scary.
If I can just ask one more thing, because I think your voice is so important here, but there's a lot of people who are watching right now who have not been affected by this, and they're feeling fine. They don't know anybody who's contracted the coronavirus. How do you best convey risk in a situation like this?
Well, if we do the shutdown properly, the percentage of people who get infected will actually be very low. That's the idea, is to not get up to like 1%, which, you know, then is 4%, 16%, 64% if you keep letting it exponentiate that way. So you have to stop well short of that 1%. You know, the damage, there will be a lot of economic damage. Somebody who owns a restaurant, somebody, you know, who's now, their job is not there. That, will have to be creative on this new ground, how we do things like relief packages to help out and minimize a lot of that pain. But the medical risk, if we do this thing well, the chance that you're going to get coronavirus and die of it is not super high. There are other diseases that will still be killing more people during this time frame if things are done well. We're really focused on this because we need to be to change the behavior, to nip it in the bud at modest percentages of the population.
Well, Bill, thank you very much for being with us tonight, and thank you for the work that you and Melinda do all the time. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you. Great.
Just had the psychological impact of the pandemic, not only for those